back with our champion, Judy Campbell. Judy, it was just Valentine's Day. You wrote an opening poem for us for Valentine's Day?
Well, I had, yes, but I didn't get a chance to tell you that.
Well, tell us.
Well, I've won lots of cash, and I've had a great time. But I speak for all your audience when I say you're our favorite Valentine.
Oh, let's go get some more cash. Come on up, Barrett. Get to the money card. Thank you, Judy. That's very nice. Now, you relax. Don't be nervous now. Here we go. Money cards all shuffled and cut. We'll start dealing them out as we give you $200 of new money on the bottom level, three cards. Move up to the second level, we'll give you another $200 of betting money and three more cards. Remember your minimum bets of $50 till you get to the top card, the big bet. There, you must risk at least half the money.
Okay.
Good luck, Judy. You've done well so far. Let's clean it up. Here's $200. And, of course, you know you can change your base card on each of the three levels if you need to. With $200, you are starting with a six.
That's a bad card. I want to get rid of that six. Please change
it. Next card, and you must play this one. I hope it's a good change. No, seven.
No.
All right, $200 and a seven, Judy.
I'm only going to risk $50 and say higher.
$50 that this card is higher than a seven.
See?
No, it's not.
It's
a five.
Okay.
See, she said.
See?
Down to 150 with a five.
Okay, $100 higher than a five.
$100 this time higher than a five. Yes, you made up for it. Get a king. $200 lower than a king. It is a nine. $450 and up goes the nine. The other $200 of betting money is yours.
Let's change that card.
And you can now change it as you move up. With $650, you're changing the nine to an eight.
Oh, wait. I'm all of it lower.
$650, all or nothing, lower than an ace. Yes, what a five. $1,300.
Oh, but that five could be, he could be mean to me. I'm going to take $600 higher.
Big bet, $600 higher than a five. It is another king. $1,900.
Oh, a thousand. $1,500, that it's lower.
$1,500 lower than a king. Yes, for the jack. $3,400 and up goes the jack. Do you want it?
Oh, well, yes, I'll keep the jack.
You'll keep it. You must bet at least $1,700,
Judy.
There's
so many big cards out against him. It's all of it. $3,400, it's lower. And be there.
Big bet on the jack. Come on, Judy. Nothing or $6,800 lower than a jack. Yes! Chance and it paid off. Congratulations. Have you won enough money to buy the boat for your husband now?
But it might be getting bigger.
It's $13,200 worth of boat right now. Way to go, Judy. New challenger right after this. Oh, that was a gutsy bet. Okay, Judy. Gonna deal out two brand new decks of cards, and we'll meet a new challenger, Linda Caprera, coming out here. Hello, Linda. Welcome.
Thank you.
Linda, would you tell us about yourself?
Sure. I'm Linda Caprera, originally born and raised in Tucson, Arizona. I now live in Huntington Beach with my husband and five-month-old daughter, and I'm currently staying home taking care of her.
Good. Are you enjoying it?
Yes. I worked in data processing for 10 years, and this is much better.
Oh, that's nice.
I love it.
Good to have you here, Linda.
Thank you.
Have you cut the cards?
Yes.
Then we're all set to go. Linda plays the lower deck, the blue deck. Judy plays the upper cards, the red deck, and we'll start with a question to the champion. Judy, we asked 100 bachelors. If today you had to decide, these are bachelors, if you had to decide either to get married for life or stay single for life, which would you choose? How many bachelors said they would choose to stay single for life?
Oh, not too many, I don't think. They really don't want the commitment, but if they're really going to stop and think ahead, who's going to pick up those dirty socks and cook those meals? There's not going to be too many who want to stay a bachelor for life. That's going to be a low figure, at least 30 or maybe even lower.
So you say 30?
30.
I was waiting for the maybe lower. Judy says 30 would stay single for life rather than be married for life, Linda.
I know they don't like the commitment at first, but I think the older they get, the more they settle down, stay single. I think...
She says 30.
I think it will be lower.
Even lower. Well, the actual number of bachelors who would rather stay single for life is 42, not lower, Judy.
Hi.
And the champion starts off with a first look at her base card, a five.
A five. I don't like fives, but I'm going to change that one.
Changing the five to a queen.
Oh, good
to change.
Card. The next one's lower.
Lower than a queen. A queen.
Hey, all right. Higher, higher.
Higher than a three. A four.
Higher, higher.
Want to risk it higher than a four? Yes,
oh,
a ten.
I'm going to freeze right there.
Now she'll freeze, needing that one card. And Linda, before you get your first question, your back is to the wall.
Yes.
Linda, we asked 100 child psychiatrists, have you ever bribed a child to get him to behave? How many child psychiatrists have bribed a child?
I think sometimes they would have to, and maybe if it's just with a lollipop or whatever the reason may be, I say at least, 68.
68 child psychiatrists have bribed a child.
That's a hard figure. A lot of psychologists tell you not to, but that's a pretty high figure. I'm going to say it's going to be a little bit lower than that.
They'd find a way around it. Huh?
They'd find a way around it, right.
The actual number of child psychiatrists who've bribed a child to get him to behave is 44. You're right, Judy, it is lower.
Okay, let's change.
And Judy can now change the 10 to a 5.
Oh, great. Oh, the next one's got to be higher, Jeff.
If this is higher, Judy has the first game of the match for the win.
Yes!
Judy does it with a clean. Well, great win for the champion. And Janice, if you will set up for game two with the next cards off the top of these two decks. And now Linda needs this game to stay in the match. Judy, as Janice deals them out, the question goes to you. Judy, we asked 100 single women, have you ever gone to a man's apartment because you thought you could trust him, only to find out just how wrong a girl can be? Oh. How many single women said they've been that naive?
Oh, yes, probably quite a few. I don't know why women are so trusting like that, but men have this silky voice, and they just, you know, they convince you that they're
silky
harmless.
Voice does it.
Every time. I'm going to say at least 60 of them have.
60?
Yes, yes.
I knew I should have taken voice lessons, doggone it. She says that 60 have been naive enough to go along with that. Linda, what do you think?
These days, I don't think so. I think if they go, they know what they're in for. I'm going to say lower.
Lower. Silky voice doesn't get it for you.
Not me.
The actual number of naive single women who've trusted a man and gone to his apartment is, you're right, it's 47. It's lower, Linda. Linda, you start with a 3.
Higher.
Higher than a 3. It is a queen.
Lower.
Lower than a queen.
Higher.
A king. Oh, it is not lower. And the champion again gets a free chance to play an 8.
Oh, and I can't change it. We'll just take a big chance and say higher.
Higher than an 8. No, it's not higher. Couldn't take advantage of it as we fill in the spaces. We will take time out for a message of importance. These are the people to pay the bills. Please watch. That's about all the time we have for now. Linda, I've got to ask you, with a 5-month-old baby, do you have any pictures of the baby with you?
Well, it's funny. The last thing I went to do before I left for the studio was to grab a picture, because I always carry a diaper bag and not a purse. And something came up and I forgot.
No pictures?
I'm sorry,
a mother
Aaron.
With no pictures?
I'm
terrible.
Sorry.
I'm sure she'll bring one next time. We'll see you on Card Sharks. Bye-bye.
House party.
Party.
Game.
Game show.
Show dog.
Dog.
Food.
Food.
Chain.
Chain.
Reaction.
It's fun. It's addicting. It's chain reaction. Guess which word completes the word association chain?
Cry wolf. Wolf whistle?
Whistle stop.
Chain Reaction, the new game show from the producers of Who Wants to Be a Millionaire, premiering Tuesday, August 1st on GSN.
Chain Reaction.